Let's have a look at this statement. At constant pressure, volume of a given mass of a gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. That means whenever the absolute temperature increases, it results in increase in volume of the gas. It is a very basic knowledge that always gas expand with increasing temperature. Whenever we heat the temperature, whenever we heat the gas, it expands. That means its volume increases. So this is the Charles law, that volume of a gas increases with increasing absolute temperature. Now what is absolute temperature? You know there are three scales for measuring temperature. The first one is degree Celsius. Second one is Fahrenheit, and the third one is Kelvin. Kelvin scale is known as absolute scale for temperature. And whenever we represent or report a temperature in Kelvin, it is known as absolute temperature. How to convert temperature from degree Celsius to Kelvin? It is very easy. Just add 273.15 into the temperature in degree Celsius. If it is 50 degrees Celsius, just add 50 into 273.15 and you will get the temperature in degree Kelvin, or absolute temperature. So this is the relation between temperature in degree Kelvin, that is absolute temperature and degree Celsius. Now according to the Charles law, volume is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Absolute temperature is represented by capital T always. That means if we eliminate that proportionality sign, we get V is equal to KT, where K is a constant which again depends on the nature of gas. Or we can write that V upon T is constant, that is K. That is ratio of always volume and temperature for a gas is constant. Or we can write it another form, that is V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. This is very useful form of Charles law, which is used in while solving problems. That is V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2, that means, and so on, V3 upon T3. That means the ratio of volume and temperature, that is absolute temperature of a gas, is always constant. Now if we use log, so we'll get from this equation log V minus log T is constant, or log V is equal to log T. Now just see the plots of Charles law. This is when we plot a graph between volume and temperature, that is in Kelvin, we find a straight line passing through origin, because volume is directly proportional to temperature. When we report the temperature in Kelvin, the line passes through origin. But if we take temperature in degree Celsius, the line will not pass through origin, but it will be a straight line passing through at another place, other place other than origin, and it will cut the temperature axis at minus 273 degree Celsius. If we take the temperature in Celsius, the line will not pass through origin. It will be a straight line, but it will not pass through the origin, and it will cut the temperature axis at minus 273 degree Celsius. While if we take temperature in Kelvin, that is absolute temperature, then the plot between volume and absolute temperature will be a straight line passing through origin. This is the Charles law, according to which volume is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. Whenever we increase the temperature, gaseous expand, that is their volume increases. At constant pressure, again at constant pressure, at fixed amount, a fixed amount of a gas, that is number of moles is constant, and at a fixed pressure, its volume will be directly proportional to the absolute temperature. This is the Charles law. Let's try to solve a numerical problem based on Charles law. First, let me run this one. Suppose a sample of a gas has volume 200 ml at temperature 50 Kelvin. If the temperature is increased to 100 Kelvin, what will be the new volume? Initial volume was 200 ml and the temperature was, while the temperature was 50 Kelvin, if the temperature is increased to 100 Kelvin, what will be the new volume of gas? Just using our Charles' law, that is V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. The V2 here is, V1 is 200 ml, while T1 is 50 Kelvin, and V2 is unknown, we have to calculate this one, and T2 is 100. Solving this or rearranging this equation, we get V2 is initial volume was 200, when the temperature was 50 Kelvin, we increase the volume, the temperature to 100 Kelvin, that is we double the temperature, and what will be the volume? Using the Charles' law, V1 upon T1, which is equal to V2 upon T2, we get V1 was 200 ml, T2 was, T1 was 50, V2 we need to calculate, T2 was 100 Kelvin, we rearrange this one, we got this, which we solving here, 100 into 10, we get 1000 ml. That is, if we double the temperature, the volume gets increased 5 times. This was the Charles' law, according to which volume of a gas, of a fixed mass of a gas at particular pressure increases indirectly proportional to the absolute temperature. Absolute temperature means temperature in degree, temperature in Kelvin. This was Charles' law, according to which volume of a fixed mass of a gas at particular pressure is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. I hope it is clear to you. In our next video, we will discuss about ideal gas equation. Thank you.